What's happening, guys? Keith here with your July 4th edition of the Impact Report. So, much like last week, we had some news go on in the beginning of the week, so I figured I'd do a midweek video and share that with you. So, this past Sunday, it was announced that Excite Wrestling will host a taping of Impact Wrestling's one-night-only pay-per-view series next month. Excite announced that the show will take place on August 25th in Binghamton, New York. No matches have been announced yet, but once they come up, I will let you guys know. So on Monday, AML Wrestling released matches for the July 29th show, Confrontation, Impact Wrestling vs. AML Wrestling. This will be live on Twitch from the Triad stage in Greensboro, North Carolina. So we have a six-way for the Prestige title. It will be champion Billy Brash vs. Brandon Scott vs. Devin Driscoll vs. Sean Denny vs. Suicide vs. Gifted One Yaya. Now, the Twitch fans will be able to choose the stipulation for this match. The choices are gauntlet match, ladder match, or battle royal, so that's pretty cool. We have the World Tag Team title match, which will be the Extreme Horsemen versus Heavenly Bodies, Chris Payne versus Eddie Edwards, Zane Dawson versus Falaba, Jackson Stone versus Moose, Kristen Statlander versus Ali, Axton Ray versus Eli Drake, and AML champion Caleb Conley versus Matt Sydal. So it looks like a pretty good card there, and that's July 29th live on Twitch. Also on Monday, TMZ broke the news that NFL star DeAngelo Williams will be returning to Impact Wrestling on July 12th. So the article said, DeAngelo Williams is coming back. No, not to the NFL, to the squared circle. The former Steelers running back announced he's returning to Impact Wrestling July 12th after swearing he was retired just days after his debut last year. He said, I said I'd never do this again, but I'm back in the ring. Williams said he was hanging them up for good immediately after the bout, but now he's coming back to help former NFL player Moose train for the Impact World Championship at this year's Slammiversary on July 22nd. No word yet on what Williams' role will be when the match finally arrives, but we're all hoping it will include a few Samoan drops and flying shoulder tackles. So last year him and Moose faced Eli Drake and Chris Adonis. I like this a lot. I like that they're getting some more advertising for not just the July 12th show, but the Slammiversary pay-per-view as well. And I think a lot of people were saying that it was kind of a weak main event with Moose versus Austin Aries, and I think the addition of DeAngelo helps out here. He got rave reviews last year after his debut, and people thought that he had what it takes to get back in the ring and be a competent competitor, but we will see what happens here. Like I said, it's great that TMZ is hyping up the show. Hopefully this will help with the ratings that week, and maybe even potentially more buys for Slammiversary. So last, on Tuesday afternoon, Sami Callihan posted another video, this time complaining that he didn't get any recognition for helping Impact Wrestling become a part of the Chris Jericho Cruise. He said he isn't even announced for the cruise, and he expects this treatment from Impact Management because all they've done is hold himself and OVE down. He said, however, he blames it on Ring of Honor management and the wrestlers because no one answered his challenge. He thinks that Ring of Honor told Impact Wrestling Chris Jericho that if he was on the cruise with everyone else, the deal wouldn't go through. He said Ring of Honor doesn't have the balls to put anyone in the ring with him, but he said no matter what, he will be on the ship and no one on the Ring of Honor roster is safe. Between this promo and the one that Aries cut recently at Ring of Honor, where he held up the Impact World Championship, granted I'm sure he meant for all of his championships, but he was holding that one up, and he said, any promotion, any challengers, anywhere, I will show up on anyone's television, and anyone's welcome to showing up on mine. It's a new day, and we'll all work together, but in working together, we have to go to war. So, if anything, I mean, it seems like this could be the start of Impact Wrestling versus Ring of Honor. I mean, just talking about Sami Callihan on the Chris Jericho Cruise, there was mention that Chris Jericho and the Young Bucks were going to team up. I could definitely see it being the three of them versus Sami Callihan and the Chris Brothers. I think that would be a great match. And hopefully Austin Aries will defend his title on the Cruise as well. But back to Austin Aries. So him versus Moose, Slammiversary, that's all set. I think Austin Aries should go over here. Maybe have Moose and DeAngelo Williams kind of, you know, have something happen where it costs Moose the championship. Then you build up a feud between those two, maybe culminating at Bound for Glory. And then you, after Slammiversary, you kind of run with this Austin Aries open challenge deal. So maybe have, you know, at the July tapings, August tapings, whatever, just have people from other promotions show up and challenge them once, you know, even just a one-night-only deal. So I think that would be big. That would help push the shows, you know, just who knows who's going to come out this night. I really think they should run with this working together with other promotions and Aries defending the title anywhere. But yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys have a happy 4th of July for those celebrating. Everybody be safe. And I will see you guys back on Friday for my Impact review. So until then, thanks for checking out my video. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.